Hello. So we'll just wait a few minutes or a few seconds until a few more people pop on.
Absolutely.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Welcome to Cleft Corner, the second ever live stream.
Honored
Yeah.
to be here. Someone's
So,
waiting. Hi.
my mom.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Tisha.
Hey.
We're in two different time zones now. As opposed to last week, it was same time zone, but now we've got one in New York and one in London.
Yeah.
Two big cities. I
How was your day so far?
was good. Yeah, it was fine. I did my food shop. As you
Gotcha.
do. As you
Good to
do.
look at. Yeah, as one does.
it's 12 p.m. there, right?
Yeah, so I haven't, I mean, I woke up rather early and did my makeup, and that's pretty much it so far. I don't know. On the weekends, I wake up pretty late, but during the week, I wake up at like 6, so.
Wow, yeah, you need that
Yeah.
weekend, lion. Hi, Gwendolyn.
Exactly.
So, yeah, this whole live stream thing is about raising awareness of clefts and talking more about it and featuring amazing clefties and what they do and all that kind of stuff. So Naomi here does makeup and yeah, as you can see, she looks beautiful. I
Thank
love
you.
the pink.
Thank you. I don't
Very
know, I was
nice.
feeling very chipper today, so I went
It
with
matches your
pink.
jumper as well. Yeah,
Yes, I did my makeup. I was like, what matches? I was like, this bad boy
I've
right
seen
here.
you wear that a few times. I do like it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I am a
So,
fashion repeater, what can I say?
oh, I mean, I wore this yesterday for my live stream, so.
Oh, it's Christmas.
Yeah, exactly. Snowflakes. It was out. I wasn't going to start taking something new out. But I wanted to be festive, so.
I always say in quarantine, yesterday's pajamas are tomorrow's outfit. So
motto.
that's,
So,
yeah.
Naomi and I met through a chat on Messenger, a mutual friend, Flo, and yeah, we're like in this little Cleftomaniacs, we're called, chat, and we just sometimes chat about clefts, and it's nice to relate to each other and talk to people who've been through the same thing as you. So can you explain? So we both have clefts, for those of you, I mean, I think everyone watching knows us or knows me. So
Yeah.
it's no surprise that I have a cleft, but yeah, will you explain a bit what yours is, quite like Deirdre's last week actually? So just explain which one you have and yeah.
I have a bilateral cleft lip, and it was pretty severe when I was born. I also have it like through my palate, so it's a complete thing. Actually, when I was born, my surgeon said to my mother that it was the worst cleft they saw in 20 years, and that they weren't sure they were going to be
Wow.
able to do it all in one go. Thankfully, they did, and here I
Yeah, I
am.
mean, they always kind of have to, not they don't want to bring your hopes up too much. They always have to kind of like say, okay, we'll see what we can do about that. But like pretty much now, like when you see kids, like I mean, it's done so well now, so well.
Yeah,
Even
absolutely.
like
I'm really
mine
lucky. I
really well.
feel really good on it.
Yeah, like mine's barely noticeable in some pictures and stuff, or like things like that. I think it's more noticeable in person or in certain pictures or,
I'm
yeah.
that way. A lot of people have a hard time like noticing it when I'm like looking straight, but when I go like this, then they're
Oh
like,
yeah, like if you're
oh
just
yeah.
behind the back. Yeah, deviated septum. Fun times. So since you do makeup, let's talk a bit about that. How did you get into makeup, first of all?
Okay, that's an interesting story, actually.
I
It was more of a unexpected thing for me.
think I've heard
I what?
I think I've heard this one, but for the people watching, refresh my memory.
Yeah, no problem. So, I have, other than my cleft, I have this other autoimmune condition called CRMO, and I got that. I started feeling the symptoms of that when I was around 11, and it was a very 0 to 100 situation for me. So I went from being a completely normal, or at least like halfway normal person that was 11, running around doing whatever, and then I slowly started to lose my ability to walk or do normal things. So, the one summer where it all started, I was kind of bedridden and I couldn't really do anything. So I started watching YouTube, and YouTube was pretty much at its infancy at that time. So there weren't that many creators. And I saw a girl named Talia who got popular on Ellen, and I started watching her content, and she was all about makeup and positivity. And as someone who was taking like chemo medication at that time, it was very motivating for me to see someone move through it, because if you have been through a similar situation, it's really painful, and you're sick all the time. So I got into makeup from watching her videos. I sent my mom to a Rite Aid and I was like, hey, here's my list of things I want you to pick up for me. And I would practice all day and all night until my eyes swelled up from like wiping it off. So that's how I got into makeup. I was not good at first. I definitely wasn't.
It definitely takes
I,
practice.
yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I look back at
So that's
like
how I got into it.
12-year-old me, and I'm like, "What? I did not know how to do makeup." Even in my teens, like I'm trying to remember. I'm like, "How did I do my makeup? I don't really like." Yeah, you definitely takes time and practice, but you're
Trial and
amazing at
error is everything.
it.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
No problem. So one thing that's cleft related is how do you find doing your lips and your scar area? You know, what are your tips and tricks? Because obviously, when your lips are not even like us, it's hard. I mean, I have a friend who has normal lips, and one time she said, "Oh, I find it hard." I'm like, if you find it hard, you know, it's double hard for us.
It's definitely a hard thing. I hear that through a lot of makeup artists, that lips are pretty much the hardest thing to do, because
Different for
they're a
everyone.
very mobile part of the face. So what I do, I first start off with like concealer in that general area. For me, I'll like turn around. You see, I have a protruding lower jaw, so that means I have to, from the straight on perspective, I have to try to correct that. So what I would do is I would go in with a concealer that maybe is like a shade lighter or two shades lighter in that area to kind of bring it forward, because makeup is all about contours and highlights. So if you want to bring something forward, you always use something lighter, and if you want to bring something backward, you always use something darker. So I put a lighter concealer in that general area, and then I go in with a lip liner, which, I mean, that's the solution to most of the problem. Like if you want to line your lips in a more even way, I mean, it is trial and error. There have
Definitely.
been many times where I've gone out looking like Bozo the Clown because I overlined or I underlined. For me, I always overline because it's just easier for me to overline my lips, because my top lip for me is like non-existent.
I know. Yeah,
Checked
I'm mindful
out.
on people as well.
I got out of it because I had my cleft is a part of a Vanderbos, so you have your normal cleft, and then you have the lip pit on the bottom of your lip. So my bottom lip is also slightly misshapen when they were trying to get the lip pit out. So I always have to like keep going over and over and over again with lip liner.
So, like, so many times I've had to wipe it off, redo it. With darker colors, it's almost harder. Always. And yeah, it's definitely a struggle for sure. I got my makeup done recently for the photos for my EP, and I was so surprised. I don't know if she's seen someone with a cleft before. I think we may have spoken about it a little bit because I talked about Operation Smile or whatever. But literally, she made my lips look so even. I was like, has she done my lips before? I was like, wow. And she doesn't have a cleft or anything. So, I mean, she's worked in film and stuff, so she's probably seen all sorts of people. So yeah, but I thought that was so cool. Like, she just made them look so good and so normal.
Yeah,
Yeah, it's
I don't
definitely
think I've ever had
difficult.
someone who's done my makeup that has done my lips properly. I remember one time I went to a MAC store, and this was very like a very long time ago when I like first started getting into makeup. So I'm gonna say I was about like 13, and this was when like orange lipstick was like a big thing. So she was like, "Let me give this a go. Let me try." I was like, "Okay, try." Not very positive about that. She literally made me look like Bozo the Clown, like fully out of my lip line. It was a mess. Oh boy. But so that was what I had to go off of. I had to learn on my own. It's definitely trial and error. Always try to, I think the best tip for like lip liner I can always give is start with the Cupid's bow first. And try to like even it out that way and then work around it. That's what I say.
Or
But
lack
yeah.
thereof. I mean, I
Back
don't really
row, yeah.
I'm completely flat here.
Yeah.
Completely.
No, like for me, like I'll go in like Zuma Olympic face. Yeah, I always have to like draw it on. I mean, there is like a like indentation, but it's a very small indentation, probably from scar tissue or something.
I mean, we had nothing there, you know, it was open. It's
Yeah.
that's the
For me, it was
reality of it.
completely open.
For you,
Yeah.
like, this is one side, but yeah, still, it's just, yeah, the struggle of makeup. Let's see, what I wrote down. Oh yeah, in regards to makeup in general, do you have any Christmas looks planned? Are you know, thinking of doing festive looks for your feed?
I mean, sure. I mean, if you have any requests, I would love to have some
Could you like
requests.
a
I'm
little
definitely not
collar or
interested.
something in the corner?
Yes, you want me to do like a
You
snowflake or
could.
something?
Oh, that would be cute. That
I'll
would
definitely
be
do
cute.
that.
Yeah, you
I'm
should.
definitely not, but I totally should be. I
I
think
need to
right
get.
now it's more important than ever.
Yeah, I need to get more like things that I could probably draw more with, like obviously liner type things, so you can actually draw. I need something like a white one. I think of a white pencil, but it's obviously not strong enough to. It's just a pencil. It's not like liquid or anything. But I definitely need to get more stuff like
White
that to like.
eyeliner for harvest.
Yeah, I need to get some of
Something
that.
like that.
Definitely. So, kind of leaning on
Harvest
from
look or something. What?
that.
Sorry.
What were you saying? No, I think sometimes this is a delay or something. What were you saying?
Yeah. I was saying always go in with like this is my recommendation. I haven't really found like a pure liquid liner that I've liked. So if you could find like a cake liner where you like add water to it.
And then you get
That's
a
like
paint
the best.
or brush. Yeah. Cool.
Absolutely.
Cool.
That's cool.
So in regards to the beauty world and representation in the beauty world, I mean, there's not many people like us represented
No.
anywhere in general. It's hard to find many examples of good portrayals of us in the media. We were talking about that last week. But in the beauty world, like, I know you've had quite a lot of, not a lot of backlash, but you've had comments and things like that, not so nice. Yeah, if you could go into that, maybe talk about how you feel it, how you feel we're represented in the beauty world.
I could definitely do that. I mean, I think, well, the first off is there aren't really many people like us, period, like in media at all. There's very little to no representation at all. So I knew from the jump that this was not going to be something that is gonna sit well with a lot of people. That's just, it's just like a realization that you have to make. It is what it is. And originally, I started doing my makeup page a couple of years ago, and I had to stop because I was just getting these comments that were so utterly like gross. Like, I had someone tell
Uninitiated.
me my lips look like I swallowed a curling iron, and I was like, at first, I was like, how'd you come up with that? Did you
Yeah,
like
that's
kiss it
very
first?
specific.
Like what are you doing in your free time? Because I'm not doing that.
No.
But I wasn't prepared at that time for it. And I think it's something if you want to do, you have to be prepared for that. And I'm at a point in my life where I'm like, you know, I'm 21 years old. I know who I am and I know what I have to offer. And for me, it's more important for me to show myself and try to be a voice for other people and kind of be that shield for other people. So I don't really, I mean, it hurts me sometimes because it'll take you very off guard because most of my comments are generally positive and I'm very lucky for that. But it takes you off guard. Like you'll have like a random weird comment and you're like, whoa, wait, what?
I know.
Where'd
I've
you
had
come
that on
from?
my
I don't
YouTube.
know
Not,
you.
yeah, not cleft related, but I
It's
have had
always.
some random comments like, okay, I'll just ignore you. I don't know what you're getting
Yeah.
at, but just gotta ignore them.
Yeah, you just gotta ignore it. But like for me, I'm a thinker. I can't generally ignore things off the bat.
Yeah, I get you.
How I
Same.
see it is just like I feel so sorry for those people that, you
Yeah.
know, they must lack education, they must lack, you know, personal boundaries, and they obviously lack a quality life because if they had a
Exactly.
quality life and they were living their best lives and,
They
you
wouldn't be doing
know,
that, you know.
making this and having fun. They would have no time. They would have no
Exactly.
time, and they would see me on their
Yeah.
timeline and be like, okay, well, that's that chick, whatever. Instead
Yeah.
of, you
People
look
worrying.
like you
Yeah.
swallow the curling. Like, who does that? Like,
I know.
you know.
It's sad. It's sad that people will say horrible things just because they're not happy or whatever is going on in their life because
Yeah,
they have nothing
it's, I feel
to
bad for
do.
them. I have
Yeah.
a question for you regarding that.
Okay.
You know, we're living in a internet age where cancel culture is a big thing. Do
Oh
you
yeah.
think those people are worthy of cancellation? Should we, you know, give certain people a pass for that? Can people change? Like, what do you feel about
I
that?
mean, I think it's very harsh. Like
Yeah.
sometimes things happen and we're human and yeah, there's some bad people or people make mistakes. But like I saw something the other day about someone who I didn't know who it was and I'm just like, let's just stop getting into people's lives. Let's stop like analyzing every little detail of people's lives and being like, oh, we gotta cancel them because they did this. And it's just like, I don't know, I think it's just too much.
I
You
think it
know?
is too. I think we've all like, you know, I said some pretty stupid stuff as a kid, like made
Yeah.
weird comments to people. I
Exactly.
always feel bad, like whenever like I think about it, like, oh, I said something that one time to that one
Yeah,
person. I wonder if
I
they
know, yeah.
remember it. And I'm just like, oh man. And for me, it's just, I think people do change. I know a lot of the people that used to bully me as a kid have absolutely changed and become better
Yeah, I think
people.
so too.
So I don't want to cancel that. But that was
Yeah.
a question someone asked me, so I thought I'd relay it to you.
Yeah, of course. And in regards to bullying, like obviously it's never gonna leave us. Like I don't know about you,
No.
but me, I'm not.
No.
People are like, forget about it. I'm like, I can't forget. I saw something good actually, was it yesterday or today? I shared it on one of my Instagrams and it was like, let go. You don't need to forget about the past, you don't need to like push it out or anything. Just let go of it, but you don't need to, it doesn't mean like that you're getting rid of it or that you're forgetting it. It happened. There's nothing you can do about that. But yeah, I saw something like that. But it's always going to stay with us. But what was your
Yeah, no,
experience with bullying
that
like?
kind of thing.
Yeah.
It always does stay with you. I mean, for me, it stayed with me for a very long time, and it affected how I saw myself. It affected how I went about, my sharing my talent. And from there, I'm so happy to see you after so long. Oh,
Someone from
who are you?
Operation Smile? Yeah, Operation Smile, right? Yeah. I'm like, how
Awesome.
do I do this? Yeah, it's someone from Operation Smile. Oh, that's lovely.
But
yes.
yeah, it's something that does sit with you. But for me, what helped me get through it is forgiveness, not for the sake of the other person, but for the sake of myself, because I have to forgive that person, but also forgive myself for having those feelings, like, and entertaining that, because we're all our own worst critics, and we can all sometimes
Yeah, ISLC 2017. Yeah, I remember your name. I was just like, it was Operation Smile, right? Don't want to get these things wrong.
that's just how I feel. Just because it'll always hit you at random moments, at least for me it does,
Oh
especially
yeah,
in quarantine.
if I just start thinking about even something completely unrelated, or I'm upset about how someone acted towards me or whatever, literally I'll just start thinking about every single thing that happened in primary school with bullying, and then I just
Same.
like I go into a spiral, and it can be just a comment from someone, and it could just like make me go down that rabbit hole of remembering everything. Yeah, it's definitely like. Did you get called names, or was it just kind of in general bullying? Was it like, did they mention your cleft much? Because I know for me, only a few times it was specifically the cleft, but I know that it was overall because I was different. I'm half Belgian,
Yeah.
I'm short, I've got small feet, I'm shy, I have a
Hey,
cleft.
small feet, you can get kids' size shoes. That's what I say.
That's
Everyone's like, oh,
true.
your feet are so small. I'm like, I could save
Yeah.
money. That's
That is true. I got a pair
money
of
in my
Vans.
pocket.
They were kid size Vans, and they have the same ones as adults. So yeah, but yeah, basically it was a, I think it was an accumulation of things. Also, a lot of the kids had like big cars, big houses, expensive toys. I didn't have all that, so I think it was
Yeah.
everything. But for you, do you feel like it was a lot about the cleft, or just in general, they just, a lot of the kids are quite troubled. I feel like that bully. A lot of them had broken homes and things like that, so I feel like they always lash out because of things like that. But what do you think? What do you find with your experience?
I think the things that stuck most with me was not only, I could say in terms of like grade school, it's always a mix of things. I was always someone, I mean, when I got older, mostly, I was always someone that refused to be quiet. And if I saw something I did not think was right, especially like other people bullying, I was like, I'm not, we're not doing that. I'm not going to entertain it. That's not going to happen by me. And I would always say something, and I would always paint a big target on my back. And that's what it was in school. But the things that always stuck with me were, I think, the complete strangers on the street that would come up to me. I remember like shopping in Forever 21 with my friends like years ago. And I had like a man, I had no idea who he was, just like went up in my face and said, "Why the fuck did you do that to your face?" And I was like, I just, he walked away, and I was just like, "What? I
What?
don't see that." Yeah, it was a very
That's
peculiar
weird.
thing. It's very weird. I've had things like that happen to me all the time. And so in high school, it was definitely a mix of things. It was, I wouldn't be quiet. I wouldn't tolerate really bad behavior. And I would not mesh in with other people. Like, if there was something I didn't like, I went to a very small boutique-y high school where everyone was extremely wealthy and I was not.
Like my primary school, kind
Everyone
of.
had like nice cars, they had the
Yeah,
Louis
I feel
Vuitton
you.
backpack, and
That was my primary
that's not
school.
how I want to be.
No.
And so I think it was that mix of things and just being different.
Yeah.
Whatever you are, if you're different at all, people are going to look at you and nitpick you and try to take you down one by one. If they think
Always.
you're more successful, then they're going to say, oh, it's because of that. Or, and they'll try to take you down a few pegs. And, I feel really bad for them more than me because, like, I'm focusing on me. I don't know what's wrong with you. That's just me.
I know that a lot of the kids in primary school, I mean, I know, I'm assuming that a lot of them were afraid of going against their friend, like you. None of them were like you. And it would have been great if a
Yeah.
few of them were, because what they didn't realize was if they were backing me up, they would have had a friend in me. Whereas when they were just watching their friends bully me, it's like,
Yeah.
you actually, why are you friends with them? If you stood up to them, yeah, they might not like you anymore, but at least you have a good friend in me.
I mean, that's true. I mean, I think I'll share like a very like bad experience. In high school, like my high school, it wasn't like going up to someone's face and saying, this is what I think you are. It was very sly. It was very under the table. It was mostly towards not like if it wasn't towards me, it was mostly towards like people with developmental delays. Or like some like autism or something, and they would pretend to be their friends so they could make fun of them to their face, and they couldn't
That's horrible.
comprehend because they didn't
Yeah.
have those cues.
I've had
And
fake friends.
and there was this one guy in specific that really terrorized me in high school. I mean, like terrorized me. And so what he did was we were friends. Like, hey, Olive, hi. So like the first thing. Like in a freshman year, we were best friends. We were like this. And like I said, the first year of high school, everyone's trying to get their footing. And everyone knows who I am. You can't, like, when you look like this, you don't, people notice. And people will always pay attention. Oh,
Yeah,
yeah.
got a few comments. I'll read them out in a
You have a
second.
beautiful daughter. We spoke the other day. She has a beautiful daughter. And so it was like extremely calculated. And so everything he would say to me was extremely specific. Like, oh, like, and it wouldn't just be my cleft, it'd also be like the color of my skin. Like,
Yeah, like my
yeah.
height was, they'd all gather around in the school playground and they'd all be like, "What shoe size are you?" What? And then they'd ask me because they know that
I
mine was small,
never heard that. That is the most ridiculous
Oh,
and
well,
like
you haven't been to
also
Ireland.
like
You haven't been to an Irish
like
preschool. Yeah, no.
so odd. I maybe they're just more vicious here. Like they'll come up to you and be like, I think you are blank. I think you're
Oh yeah,
this. And like,
I do things like that as well.
oh my God, it was
Like, you're weird.
brutal. They'd write you
You're gay.
letters and
You're
like
weird.
they would pretend to like me and want to
Oh
date
yeah.
me and like show interest in me, and like they like this would be like a time consuming thing, and I think some of them actually did. Like the one guy that was the worst, I know he did. And so as soon as his friends would take notice that he's like texting me, he'd be like, haha, just kidding, fuck you. And I'm like, what?
I
And
had
I'm
a
like,
guy
why
friend
don't
when I was
you
little,
like grow up?
similar thing.
Like I was just like, grow up, dude. Like I'm sorry. You want to be someone's henchman? That's totally like we're obsessed with shoes. I've never heard of that here. That is not a thing here.
Oh yeah, it was
That's
just
so
anything that
strange.
was different. Like, oh, you don't have designer. Why don't you ha literally, I got the question, why don't you have designer clothes? Like, I don't have money for
I
that kind of stuff.
Even if I did, like even if I did, I wouldn't want it. Like that's not my thing. Like I can like something and save up. Like I have like a lot of makeup. I'm not rich.
Oh no, like
Every
underneath for
single
everything.
thing I have, I worked hard for and I used with my own money.
Exactly.
Like
I
don't tell
know.
me anything.
These kids
And
got
if I
expensive
want
things.
something, I save up for it, and I can save up
Yeah.
for it.
Yeah.
But typically speaking, I don't want to walk into school with a shirt that's like Gucci, 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 Gucci.
Oh
Like,
yeah,
that's just
I
not,
know.
that's, I, that's some paid advertising, but like, that's me paying to be an ad. Nope.
Yeah, so it is
Yeah,
anti-bullying.
that's
So, sorry?
no, so every like
Oh.
here it was extremely calculated
Oh,
and
yeah.
vicious. It was vicious. Like, I think you're poor and you're brown, nothing. Like, I was just like,
What? Yeah.
but let's we're up here. Let's take it down here, 'cause
Yeah.
no. Like, there, it was just
Yeah.
anyway, moving
Yeah,
past that.
it's
I
anti-bullying
think,
awareness week. That's why I was kind of like, let's talk a bit about that. Because that
yeah.
obviously is a big topic this week. Should we read some of
Whenever
the
I'm in
comments?
like, oh, okay, I was gonna say one thing, like
Yeah, no,
one
go
thing.
ahead, shoot.
Whenever I'm in, because in the States we have an organization called My Face, and
Okay, yeah.
I attend a lot of their younger meetings mostly. I'll
Okay.
be like the oldest person there because I feel as though I want to be that person that people can depend on and look towards because
Yeah.
we're important.
Yeah.
And I always tell these kids, bullying, you cannot avoid it. It doesn't matter where you are, it doesn't matter what happens, it's gonna follow you. If someone's not gonna like you, someone's not gonna like you.
Oh yeah.
What adults need to do and that, what parents need to do, and I always say it to every parent that I meet, is
Yeah.
train your child to have good self-esteem. Remind your child who they are,
Yeah.
because if someone is telling your child, oh, you're this, you're this, you're this, you're this, and you're not backing that up and telling your kid, you know what, you're so talented, you're so good looking, you have this, that, and this,
Yeah.
it's not. Kids do really bad things when they don't feel as though they have anything to live for. They do bad things
That,
when
like, they're
they
worth
don't
nothing, yeah.
feel effective. And so that's always something I always put emphasis on.
Yeah,
Treat your kids to
definitely.
be confident in
Yeah,
themselves.
I said something like that
And
last
that
week.
gives.
Yeah, it's very
Yeah.
important. Should we read some comments? So we've got Deirdre says, completely agree, letting it go and choosing not to let the hurt rule your life. And then some hearts. And then Mega Sierra says, when somebody tries to demean you, it reflects their personality, so don't ever listen to them because you exactly know who you are, and that's more important. Very true. Click wave. Oh, I'm pressing on the wrong thing. So then you know Olive, and yeah. We saw that comment earlier. And then my oldest had bilateral cleft lip and palate, and my youngest has autism. Yeah, so
She sent me a picture of her daughter last night, and she was
uh-huh.
gorgeous, drop dead gorgeous. Oh man, she
I
should be a
keep swiping
model.
up. And then there was a
Bullying is
thank
not
you.
okay, and that's why I was a loner in school. Art is the only thing that got me through it. Yes.
Yeah.
I never left the art room at school.
I just
I
feel
just feel
so
so
proud
proud
of
of
you.
you.
To
Oh,
how
thank you.
brave you handle every situation. Oh, we're obsessed with shoe size and art. Yes, we are. And we have a question actually. Oh, Deirdre. Okay. Do either of you ever feel strange, awkward, or more selfish? I can't speak. Self-conscious at makeup counters.
Yes.
I
Yes,
don't know.
because people just automatic, like, I think, I don't know if it's necessarily makeup. People automatically assume I know nothing, and they're like, yes, so this is what we're gonna do. And I'm like, sweetie, let's take a step back. I know what I'm doing. Or they'll automatically assume I'm stealing something, which is not cute,
Really?
not about it.
I don't think I've
Profiling.
had that. I don't think I've had that. But if anyone else has any more questions, you can either comment, or it's maybe easier to do the little question mark thing. What's considered a bad shoe size in Ireland? So I have a size 2, sometimes 2.5, and in a Converse
Do
I'm
you
a
know what that
3 for
is
some
in US
reason.
conversion?
I don't know.
I'm looking
Google.
this up. I want to
I'm
look this
gonna,
up.
I'll Google it. I'll Google it. Wait. Why do they have to make
Because
things
I'm a size
complicated?
of 7.
So I don't know what that is. Size 2 in US. UK to US. UK to US. Yeah, so I have a small shoe size, and like people are just I've literally always gotten this. Like even in secondary school where people were nicer, always like, "Oh, you're so small." Yeah, I hate when people say, "You're so small." I'm like, "Well, I know I'm small, so don't tell me." Or, "Oh my gosh, your feet are so tiny. How cute." You're like, "No, just leave me alone."
Hey, I would love for someone to tell me that my feet are cute. I've
Well,
had the fifth year
the
where I
cute
was like told to avoid both lip colors and drawing attention to my lips. Yes,
is okay, but yeah.
yes.
I have
That
gotten
bugged
the
me
color.
all the time. I was
So.
like that emo kid in high school. Like I was emo. I wore bright purple lipstick. What I th who I thought I was, I don't know. Because that was not a complimentary shade. That just wasn't it for me. Like, no. But I wore bright purple, and people are like, "Don't you think that's like unflattering and drawing attention? Like, don't you want that unnecessary attention?" I was like, "Excuse me. Excuse me. I'm gonna
Do what
draw
I want.
attention wherever I go anyway. Anyway."
Might as well emphasize it.
So, yeah. And there's
Yeah,
nothing wrong with
definitely
a lot
not.
more than what we have. Nothing wrong with it at all.
No, I know, I don't know if my mom won't mind me saying that my mom in the past when I was a teen would be like, "Oh, that color's quite bright," and I think she was just worried about me.
Yeah, no.
But if you just like embrace it, you know, I just embraced it and it was fine. I think if I can like just if I'm wearing a really bright color, the trick is to like line it and to make it look more
Yeah.
even. But in regards to the shoe sizes, a size 2 is a sa no, that's UK. Oh wait, I'm confused. That's not right. USA is written over, I think, the UK ones because you guys are bigger than our size. And then UK, I don't want to look at that side. That's not very accurate.
I'm learning something right now.
Oh, right, that's clothing size. I should probably put the word shoe in there. Whoops.
Your
So a
sizes
size
are
2
very small.
is 4.5. A size 2 is 4.5. And a 34 in
Oh
European.
my God. Oh my
Sometimes
God,
I'm
you have
2.5,
feet.
sometimes I'm 5 or 2.5, and sometimes I Converse for some reason. Converse, I'm a 3, or I'm guessing that's a 5.5. Yeah,
This isn't
let's see what
kids or in
Converse.
women.
Yeah, I have a lot of like kids shoes, but there's some shops that like specialize. Like in Belgium, there's a shop that specializes in small shoes, and I went there once and I got some shoes that fit. What? Yes, I've had. Oh, we read that one. I have big feet for my height, so I guess I'm glad I didn't grow up in Ireland. Yeah, and it's really hard to find shoes in the shops there as well. I feel like some countries maybe it's easier. Like Italy would probably have a lot more choice because you know they're big into shoes.
Yeah, China too, because
Yeah,
like small
Mexico.
feet are considered the ideal. There's
In
nicely
Mexico, I
into
got.
adult shoes. I get so
Yeah.
sad because I was not size 3. I've never heard
Not
like
size five and a half.
this is getting me. I wish I got made for my shoes. I call my feet boat feet because they're just super skinny and long. So like I have like clown feet. So oh man.
Yeah, and it was
Much
also.
rather get like, oh, your big toe sucks, rather than,
Yeah.
you know what,
No,
your
it was
forearm
also.
hurts.
It was size and everything. Like I had a big backpack. Oh, that's why do you have such a big backpack? You're so tiny. It makes you look so small. And it's like, well, you know, we've a lot of books to carry, and if I get a tiny backpack like you, it's gonna break. So,
Yeah, no, that's crazy.
honestly,
I have a
small
good
shoe sizes
question.
in
I have a
dress.
question about
Yeah,
like,
because
did you have a
shoes
lot
are
of
too.
diversity in your school?
In my secondary school, yes. I went. I we went. I we my sister and I went to a very diverse secondary school. There were I don't know the statistics, but I will tell you that in some classes there were maybe more foreigners than there were Irish girls in some classes. That might have been the case. We literally so diverse. Primary school in my class, maybe we had one half Asian kid at one point. I can't remember where they were from, where their parent was from. Once, and
Because I
everyone else
assume when
was
you're in a school where people are kind of all the same, they kind of
white.
have to like get creative and pick
There
something.
you
They're like,
go.
okay, we're all white. We all have this color hair. What do we do? Feet. Let's go with feet.
Being hiding bags, whatever. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's funny, isn't it?
But.
It's definitely an interesting one. I've just got some photos of myself as a baby for anyone who may never have seen, because last week I was trying to look for a photo and I wasn't prepared. But for anyone who has not seen a craft, I will show you. So that's me as a baby
Oh, you are so
before
cute. Stop.
before my first operation. So
Stop.
that's what my cleft looked like, and that's one side there. And Naomi had the two sides. See if we can find a
Was
face
yours
on the
complete?
picture. Huh?
Is yours complete? Like, does it go through the no?
Yeah,
Okay, yeah.
it is. So there you
It
go.
is.
My mom's favorite picture. And is this one
You look
after
like a little
surgery?
cute little
Oh no, that's
baby.
before. I have one like I have There we go. Post-op
I'm pretty
after
sure
the baby.
mine are up if anyone wants it. Mine were are a
Yeah,
little bit more.
I have some
My
shared.
maxilla was like twisted out of my mouth. So.
Incubator.
Oh. Do you have a cheat tube too? Did you have like any feeding problems?
I think yeah, I think my mom found it hard to get me to eat things. And that stuck for a very long time. I'm quite a fussy eater.
Oh yeah.
And it's something that has stuck with me. And I've seen a YouTuber talk about it recently, and I realized that there is a condition, like it has a label, so I'm pretty sure that's what I have. But
Yeah.
it's not something that concerns me too much anymore, because I live, like, I cook for myself, so I don't have to worry about other people putting food in front of me.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think my mom definitely struggled to get me to eat at the beginning. And it's hard, because like our lips have to, like, I don't know about you, but right, like always I have more it's more a weaker here in my lip, so where the cleft, where
Yeah.
everything was put together, like if I try to lift it, it's just a lot harder than the other side, for example. Yeah, it's like it's
I'm like,
just it's
do I
a
lift
lot
it?
slower. Yeah, it's like the nerve endings. So when you're like a cleft baby trying to eat and learning to eat, it's definitely not easy.
No, I had a
No.
G tube actually.
Oh,
So
really?
I had that for a while. And then I had feeding therapy,
Mm-hmm.
which is awful because they'd sit you on a table and they're like, okay, you want to leave? You want to go home? You want to play outside? You're going to eat this. And I was like, uh-uh-uh. And they're like, uh-huh. So there are certain foods I cannot look at without like getting like, oh, like the skeevies. Like they would have me we eat peas. Peas give me the skeevies. And
Really?
I don't know if you have these in Ireland. They're called Teddy Grahams. They're graham ca crackers in the shape
Oh
of
yeah, we
teddy
don't have
bears.
graham crackers. I don't think
I
you can
do,
get
and I
graham
like
crackers in
it.
the
You don't eat
UK.
graham crackers?
No, we don't
Do you
have
not
that
have
in
s'mores?
the UK or Ireland. Well, if we were to eat s'mores, I would get like rich tea biscuits, which I think are similar enough. Rich tea, you would dip in tea easily. Like, they're just really nice plain biscuits. Deirdre said so cute. Oh, thank you. Yeah, we don't have graham crackers, but yeah, they don't exist here.
I'm learning so much right now. I'm
Yeah.
like having the best time. That's so crazy.
How long have we been going on for? I feel like we've been talking a long time, so we might have to, yeah, they're digestive, yeah, digestives, or rich tea, they're quite similar. Digestives are a little bit like, I don't know how to describe it, more not crumbly, but like a bit drier than the rich teas, maybe. But if you look up that, like, they're the two that would go the best with s'mores, with marshmallows and chocolate, I feel like definitely.
So I have
They're
a
one
fun,
what I would use.
like, big
Yeah, before we
question.
go, yeah.
So when it comes, because I think we've spoken about this, you and I mostly a lot, about representation and what that means. What does representation mean to you? Do you feel as though like the lack of representation has affected, your career or your career goals? And how do you feel we can combat that as a community?
I
Like
definitely feel
that's
like,
a very loaded question,
yeah, wait,
but
repeat that. My brain just went.
so
That was me in school
what
all the time.
does, yeah, it's fine.
Questions like that, I was
What
like,
does yeah,
what? Okay, repeat.
totally fine. What does cleft representation in media mean to you?
Deidre.
Bye, Deidre.
Slán go fóill, it's Irish for goodbye. I can't remember what phone
Oh.
in means, but slán is goodbye. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, the last question. Okay. Repeat
So
it.
what does representation in the media for clefs mean? Like, what would that do for us, and how do you feel like we should go about it?
Well, it would be amazing, wouldn't it? Like,
Yeah.
I mean, the only person I can think that I knew of when I was younger was someone in Girls Aloud. Can't remember what her name is. It's a gr it's an a
Send
British
Iris.
band. No, British, UK.
Oh.
Yeah, Google it later. I can't remember which one has a cleft. I know. I think it's Girls Aloud. Girls Aloud cleft. Let's see what her name is. I can't remember which one it was. No. Was it Girl? I can't remember. One of those bands. But that's the only one I heard of, or that I knew of back then. So definitely, I think representation would be amazing because all the little clefties out there, like us, would have people to look up to and people to be inspired by. And like, I definitely want to show, like, I'm a singer. And you know, the first question my dad asked when I was born, will she be able to sing? Because music's important to my family. And I can. So I want to show that, like, I know I've heard of other singers as well. And I want to show that it is possible despite the airflow difficulties, the nasality, all of that. And actually singing, like I said last time, I think, has helped me a lot with my breathing, for sure. And my control and my voice and my nasality and all of that. But wait, I'm running off on the tangent now. What was the rest of the question again?
How do you feel, like, you answered the first part. How do you feel we can go about attaining that?
Oh yeah,
How
right.
can we work together to get there?
Definitely you and I, people like us, doing just keep going on social media, doing these talks, and doing makeup and showing that we can do things, definitely. Like I said, I'm a singer, I'm actress. I would love to be on the screen, on the stage, representing us, and hopefully someday people will maybe know who I am a little bit more, and I'll be able to show them what a cleft is and all of that. And that's what I'm trying to do. Like, my EP just came out, and it's just the beginning of that side of my career, of like releasing music. And maybe when I eventually get a record label or something, I'll, you know, be more well known. I'll be able to kind of canvas that. And yeah, I think the best thing for us to do as a community is to just keep plugging it, keep sharing it, literally annoy people, like, to the point of annoying people, like, keep putting on our stories, being like, cleft representation, and people will start to kind of just think about it more. My daughter
Yeah.
has a flute, bilateral cleft lip and palate. That's great. Yeah, like, we're showing that, you
That's
know, playing
impressive.
flute, singing. Yeah, because I mean, my dad, he does
The
these music.
airflow is just not the same. And
Yeah.
like personally, I have like a fistula, so if I like blow really hard,
Yeah,
the air will
balloon.
go windows and
Yeah.
through the roof of my house. So it's
Yeah,
kind
like
of a pain.
balloons, because I can't breathe properly through my nose. Or my dad used to make musical instruments, didgeridoo, which is an Australian, out of pipes. Australian instrument, I should have finished my phrase. Australian instrument, out of pipes. And I had tried, I think, when I was younger, and I just can't get the air out. I can't. Yeah, it's just, so it is hard for us to do things like singing, flute. It is harder because we have to work a lot more, and I've had to like figure out how to use this. So if I'm worried if I had another surgery, would I have to relearn, reteach myself how to do the breath control, so definitely. But the flute, that's great. Like, I think these things do really help with our breath control and our flow and all of that stuff, definitely. I think we should probably leave it there because we've been talking for so long. Thank you, everyone, for joining in and watching and asking questions and commenting. And thank you, Naomi, for coming on for the second ever Cleft Corner. Very exciting. Go follow Naomi. She does amazing makeup. At Naomi
Thank
Heather Makeup, right? Yeah, that's it.
you. And follow Sarah. She's an amazing
Thank
singer
you.
and active.
Thank
I
you.
love you too.
Oh, yeah, I love you. Great. So this live will be up as well on IGTV to watch, and hopefully I'll be bringing another Cleft Corner very soon. So yeah, thanks for tuning in. Goodbye, everybody.